Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today I am going to cover plastic analysis or a subject design of steel structures which is useful for civil engineering students. First of all, we will be discussing about the difference between elastic and plastic design. What is plastic design? The structure is designed for strength of steel beyond yield limit. If the structure is studied beyond yield limit, then it is said to be plastic design. If the structure is studied till the yield point, then it is said to be elastic design. For elastic design, we would be designing according to working stress method. And for plastic design, we will be using limit state method. In elastic design, working loads are considered. In plastic design, ultimate loads are considered. So these are the difference between elastic design and plastic design. For plastic analysis, first we need to understand what is plastic hinge. Plastic hinge is a zone of yielding due to flexure in structural member. We'll be studying location of plastic hinge. There are mainly three points which we should consider: point of concentric load or UDL, end of member meeting at connection, and at a point of zero shear. These are the location to consider plastic hinge. Now I'll be talking about shape factor. Shape factor is the ratio of plastic moment and yield moment. And what is load factor? It is the ratio of collapse load to the working load. Now I'll be talking about collapse load in the detail. Here is the simply supported beam with a concentric load. Here maximum bending moment, you all know, WL/4. This analysis can be static method or kinematic method. For static method, we are using just formula WL/4 equal to maximum bending moment. This we are getting collapse load WU equal to 4MP/L. And in kinematic method, we will be using external working work done equal to internal work done. External work done means load into deflection, and internal work done means moment into rotation. For external work done, W into that distance we are calculating, and equal to internal work done moment into rotation. So where there is internal hinges, there will be two hinges due to this support. So here will be two rotation, and at the end there will be one each rotation. We should keep three point in mind: hinges occur at concentric load, at the connection, and span is zero, or we can say shear is zero. Similarly, we are going for fixed beam with concentric load. In fixed beam, there will be a maximum bending moment that we will call it as WL/4, and due to fixed supports, there will be a bending moment W into L. So there are two moments. For static method, we have WL/4 equal to 2 MP and collapse load equal to 8 MP/L. We are calculating using kinematic method. External work done equal to internal work done. W into load into deflection equal to P theta plus MP theta plus theta plus MP theta. Here you can see at the supports there occurs a rotation, and at the hinge point there will be also two rotations. So our collapse load will be 8 MPa by L. Now eccentric load. For eccentric load, we have the formula for maximum bending moment, WAB by L. Using that we get collapse load MP L by AB. In kinematic method, taking from one side, we are getting WA by A into L equal to internal work done MP theta plus theta 1. That theta 1 we get AB by A by B theta. Solving it, we can get MP L by AB, which is similar to static method. Now we'll move into fixed beam with eccentric load. Due to eccentric load, we are having WAB by L, and due to fixed, there will be another moment. So there will be 2 MP. So our collapse load will be 2 MP L by AB. Similarly, kinematic method using external work done equal to internal work done. Taking one side, WA theta equal to MP theta plus MP theta plus theta 1 plus MP theta 1. Here you can see, due to bending moment of fixed, we are getting one rotation, and due to concentric load, we are getting another two rotations. So we are solving, we get 2 MP L by A by B. Now for UDL, simply supported with UDL, we have formula WL by 8 according to the static method. Collapse load will be 8 MP by L. In kinematic method, similar way, load into deflection for external and internal moment into rotation. So we get collapse load is equal to 8 MP by L. Fixed UDL, there will be, due to fixed UDL, there will be one moment, and there will be another moment due to fixed beam. So there will be two moment means UDL and fixed beam. Similarly, kinematic methods, external work done equal to internal work done, we get the formula collapse load equal to 16 MP by L. I'll be talking about propped cantilever concentrated load. For propped cantilever concentrated load, we'll be taking, first it is simply supported, and then for another we are taking it as a fixed beam. So according to the simply supported, we are getting WL by 4, and one end is fixed, there will be another moment. So there will be MP due to fixed beam and MP L by 2 by L due to that load. So solving up, we get collapse load equal to 6 MP by L. In kinematic method, external work done will be W into L by 2 theta, half portion we are taking, and similarly internal work done MP theta due to this fixed beam, and MP theta plus theta due to the concentric load. Solving it, we get 6 MP by L. For different distance, or you can say eccentric load, we get W U equal to L plus B by AB MP. For static method and kinematic method, we are getting similar answer. First will be, in kinematic method, first we are dividing the section into two parts. External work done will be W A by theta, A into theta equal to MP theta plus MP theta plus theta 1. MP theta will be due to fixed beam, and considering fixed beam and MP theta plus theta 1 for concentric load. Solving it, we are getting this results. Now I will be taking one example of continuous beam. ABC is a continuous beam with concentrated load. We will be dividing it into two parts, AB and BC. For AB, plastic hinge will be at D and for BC plastic engineering will be at E, using kinematic method, external work done and internal work done. External work done means load into reflection, load into reflection at a distance L by 2 theta. Internal work done, moment into rotation, mp theta plus theta plus mp theta, mp theta plus theta hinge at D and mp theta at point D. D point is getting twice rotation due to AB and BC also. So first part we are rotating for AB, so mp theta, there will be 3 mp theta. So by principle virtual work, external work done equal to internal work done, we are getting 6 mp by L. Similarly, we are going for another section BC, external work done equal to load into deflection, W into half section we are taking 2 by 3 L theta, internal work done mp theta plus mp theta plus theta 1, that will be theta 1 will be 2 times theta, total will be 4 mp theta. Similarly, we are using external work done equal to internal work done by principle of virtual work, we are getting 6 mp by L. We have to take the minimum collapse load from each section, so we are getting equal, so we are taking 6 mp by L is the collapse moment. Now we are going to find the collapse load for portal frame. Here is the portal frame A, B, C, D, E. First we need to check how many mechanism is required in this portal frame. So location of plastic engineering ABCD, 4 locations, degree of redundancy are equal to 5 minus 3. 5 is the reaction which would be 3 for a fixed member and 2 for hinge member. 3 plus 2, 5 minus 3 is the reaction, so 5 minus 3 is 2. Degree of redundancy is 2. Number of possible hinges, independent mechanism, n minus r. N is the plastic hinge minus the redundancy. 4 minus 2 equal to 2. Thus we know that there will be two mechanisms, beam mechanism and sway mechanism. First we will be talking about beam mechanism. Beam mechanism will be similar to our continuous beam. We will be talking about external work done and internal work done. External work done is load into deflection, W into L by 2 theta, internal work done, mp theta plus mp theta plus mp theta plus theta. Okay, mp theta means at B, mp theta at D, plus mp theta plus theta will be at C, 4 mp theta. We are getting by virtual work W equal to 8 mp by L. Now we will be moving with sway mechanism. Here there will be deflection at the columns theta, delta, we have delta, we have taken here is a deflection. External work done will be, you can say, load into deflection W into 0.5 L theta, L by 2 is the distance. Internal work done, moment into rotation, mp theta plus mp theta plus mp theta. There will be each rotation at each point. Similarly, we are getting work done, or you can say collapse load, 6 mp by L. Now we will be combining the mechanism, beam mechanism and sway mechanism. External work done will be W into L by 2 theta plus W into L by 2 theta. Internal work done will be mp theta plus mp theta plus theta plus mp theta plus theta by mp theta. External work done equal to internal work done, we are getting collapse load 5 mp by L. So our moment will be WL by 4, we all know that. So we are using the work collapse load in the moment formula, we are getting 1.25 mp, or you can say 5 by 4 mp. Thank you guys, thank you for listening.